flat spot we came to check out, and this is the way we went, obviously.
That first spot we thought might be flat.
Dog butt.
And we got some old carboy tops. Really thick metal. I mean, look at that. That's like the size of my finger, but almost a half an inch. Did I say metal? Oh, no, glass, yeah. Glass carboys. And this top, too. Old glass, old blue glass. But we're out in the middle of the woods. A lot of tea plants. And the Ocoli Howe is the old liquor they were making during Prohibition back in the day. And a little bit more old carboy trash and old Asian dish. But this is a built-up wall right across there. And we come over to this little graded area and this rock wall built. And this is retaining all this earth.
Oh.
All right. Yeah, it's the light rail from the sugarcane. Uh-huh. And a Ocoli Howe pit. So this bar metal here, the old train track from the sugarcane era. There was a lot of excess of this here. And they would put these across the pits. You can hardly tell that this is a pit anymore, but this is a pit, believe it or not. Hard to see on the camera. But this is a little pit compared to the big pit behind us. So maybe this is a dual thing. Maybe they had a Ocoli Howe going here, and this was an old sandalwood pit on this side. Same rails, that's amazing. Boy, that was something to boat or hike out. Okay, now this is the anomalous one. This is deep. I'm gonna go down in here. Stay a moment. All right. We are in a 6-7 foot deep, 6 foot deep. Probably more if you took all the debris out. Box, dirt lined, out here in the middle of the woods. And to be very curious to know what's underneath us, how far down this originally went, how much of this debris has come in. Momi, stay up there. You don't need to come down here.
Like, there's that one spot down there looks kind of like it's been flat with rocks in between those other rocks, and then this spot looks like It could just be total coincidence, but like, it feels like it's been flattened out there.
You know, I still theorize they were growing a lot of sweet potato and shit like that up in these kind of places where they couldn't get water. Big mangoes.
Oh yeah, that's a mango. Look how high we
are. Another huge mango up here. We're on a pig highway. Oh yeah, huge old mango. Yep, and mangoes like this only get here by somebody dropping a seed 100 years ago. Look at this thing's grown into this rock and just sucked it right in. I'm getting up there, I'm getting into the native forests. I'm getting into a llama forest. All this black trunk and little red leaf. Very native. There's still some guavas up in here, but it's almost all native. Getting up there. We just found our first sandalwood. That's this big beauty here. A big chunk of sandalwood up on the side of the hill with a llama and a lahala. We're just about up to the top. You can see the light through. All right. Looks like we've gotten up to the top. Woo! Oh, nice. Nice, nice, nice. A lot of animal trail. Ooh. Oh, there's sandalwood down there, yeah. And silk oaks all over up here, of course. I always felt like I could see those from a distance.
Mommy.
Yeah, a little ridge right over there would be cool to get to, but we'll see if there's a cliff right behind this knoll we're on.
Yeah, I'm pretty spooked out. What's this way? Babe.
A little steep up here. A little steep. This is about a 45 degree pitch in front of us. Maybe 40, not quite 45, I don't even like 40. With moments of 45, maybe 50s. Kind of like that angle of the grass. These are the pandanus or screw pine. They come out with walking feeding roots. And the tree can walk 20 feet over its lifetime if it wants to try and get the water. They're just a whole big cluster of them. Kind of an impressive bunch. Nuts. Oh, that is so intentional.
Oh, yeah, I'm not feeling that good.